Well, this is the reality of where the United Kingdom is today in the context of the absence of an agreement with the European Union, in particular in relation to the trading goods and the ability for goods to enter the United Kingdom, in goods which are foodstuffs or indeed medical supplies. And I think it's important that we reflect on the reality of that. This was an important headline 2 days ago. This morning, the Prime Minister is saying, rightly in my view, that it is being sensible and reasonable to address these issues, given that we may be months away from what we all hope will not be a cliff-edge no-deal scenario. But that is the situation in which the United Kingdom finds itself. It is not the situation in which Gibraltar finds itself, even if there were a no-deal Brexit, or indeed, should there be, and I certainly believe this will never be the case, a deal between the United Kingdom and the European Union which is not applied to Gibraltar. And of course, the reason why that is not going to be a relevant concern in Gibraltar, the stockpiling of food and the issue of supplies of medicines, is that this relates to the United Kingdom being pulled out of the Common Customs Union without an agreement, whilst Gibraltar has never been a part of the Common Customs Union, and we already apply tariffs and frontier controls to foodstuffs and other goods, and we will not be moving to a new regime whether or not there is a no-deal Brexit on the 29th of March next year.
We've heard you use the words hard and pure populism 5 times to describe the rhetoric of Spanish state politicians, both present and past. Can you describe the reasons why you felt it was so important to reinforce this point?
Well, I think there are different actors in the context of what I'm addressing today, which is the Gibraltar relationship with Spain, and in particular the aspects of that which relate to Brexit, that have been given to pure and hard populism, even though they might not like to be reminded of it. Of course, the dictator General Franco is not around to hear me say it, but some of his successors in political title might have reported to them some of the things I have said, and it's important that we highlight where that hard and pure populism is manifesting itself, even when it manifests itself in Gibraltar, with some suggesting that we should be harder on the United Kingdom. Well, look, I think it's important that at the moment we enjoy the strongest possible relationship with the United Kingdom. This is a very difficult time in our affairs. This is not the time for us to be picking fights with the UK in order to show bravado or pretend that we are better or worse than any other political leader.
Well, considering the audience that we have here today, you've made several references to the role of the campo in a post-Brexit relationship between Gibraltar and Spain.
Yes, indeed. I mean, I think I've said so explicitly on a number of occasions. It was important that I should say so here. In the terms that I've used in the interviews I've done around the world, I've talked about creating a rainbow of opportunities that creates wealth for every corner of the bay. In doing so, I've even avoided saying the Bay of Gibraltar, because I haven't wanted to demonstrate my partisan bent when I'm talking about the opportunity for cooperation. Because you see, the important thing is, if we say that we want to be neutral in respect of matters which relate to sovereignty, we must approach the discussion in that way. We must not hide our attempt to score goals in relation to sovereignty issues by trying to get through the opposite party the ingredients of sovereignty as if we might not notice. Well, look, the Brexit negotiating team is alive to every sinew of sovereignty that might be relevant. We're not just going to be looking out for a red and yellow flag. We're going to understand that sovereignty, jurisdiction and control and other ingredients of sovereignty make up the DNA of the sovereignty of a nation, and we're not going to allow our DNA of the British sovereignty of Gibraltar to in any way be affected in this process, which might be negative for us.